Professor Brothers, and I'm going to be going over the Agile software design process in today's lecture. So I didn't create a PowerPoint for this because there are so many really good resources online for the Agile design process, and I'm not going to go over the entire process. What I'm going to do is show you where the web page is, go over the top level, and then encourage you to go back to some of these resources and take a more in-depth look to explore this concept more. So where did it start? It started with a problem. So Agile started as a software development process. It was a reaction to the cumbersome waterfall methodology that we talked a little bit about in the engineering process lecture. That was an older manufacturing practice methodology. So the manufacturing process was that you examine the requirements, analysis, and concept, you design it, you do production implementation testing, and then the maintenance level. And so it would flow down to the different levels. This was with the mindset of you're building this widget, you're building something physical. And so once you get it designed and built, you make hundreds of thousands of these in order to bring the cost per unit down. So it was a big emphasis on the design and the documentation and putting the initial thing together, because once you start running the manufacturing line, you didn't want to disrupt that process because that's really where the money was made at. But software came around, and when they started to do software development, you know, around the mid-90s, software developers had had enough of trying to work in this manufacturing style model. So they created the Scrum and adaptive software development process, along with many others. And in 2001, there were some software developers that came together to talk about what they were doing and created the Manifesto for Agile Software Development. And this is the manifesto. And this is literally, the web page is agilemanifesto.org. So we are uncovering better ways of developing software by doing it and helping others do it. Through this work, we have come to value individuals and interactions over the process and tools, working software over comprehensive documentation. So they wanted the software to actually work. Customer collaboration over contract negotiations. And then responding to change over following a plan. Responding to change, so that is, again, taking from that manufacturing, where in the manufacturing, it was very rigid. You wanted to build the widget. They said in software, you don't have to be that rigid, so they want to be able to respond to the change. That is, where there is value in the items on the right, we value the items on the left more. So they're not saying that there's not value in following a plan, but they're saying they want to respond to the change more. And then these are the individuals at the bottom of the screen who are actually creating this manifesto. So Agile was developed. Using Agile is a process for software development, and it's a cyclic process. The first part is a plan, design, develop, test, deploy, and then review the development cycle, and then launch the product. Here is a PowerPoint presentation that was put out. I don't know what year this was actually put out, but here's the author of this, Liz, and she's a Microsoft MVP, and this is coming from Microsoft 365 World. So in this, I'm going to fast forward through a lot of this. Here's a really good illustration of the Agile process. So there are some people involved in this. The first is the product owner. The product owner is the one who really understands the customer needs. They're on the product development team, but they're the one who is the liaison to the customer team, the stakeholders, and they create this product backlog. So during the sprint planning process, the development team, the product owner, they forecast the PDIs and plan the work, the tasks for the current sprint. And then they create a sprint backlog. These are items to accomplish. They go into the sprint. So every day of the sprint, you have a scrum meeting, a stand-up, usually like 15-minute, real quick meeting to get everybody on board. And then towards the end, you have a product backlog refinement meeting in order to look what has happened. So the sprint, maximum of 1 month. These are very short processing cycles so that you can address whatever is going on in that processing cycle or that development cycle and implement it and release product. So then you have a sprint review at the end and a sprint retrospective. And you have the product patch that kind of comes out of that. Here's a big thing. 90% of a project manager, scrum manager's job is spent communicating. I'm going to ask each team in the project to designate a team leader. The team leader is going to do a lot of communication. That's one of the big things they're going to work on, right? This is an illustration of how you could do scrum planning. One of my bosses actually had this exact structure. When you walk into his office, he had a whiteboard that was covered in sticky notes that was isolated in this manner in order to keep track of where they were at in the scrum. But there's more advanced tools that you can use. So this one is actually looking at using Microsoft Teams in order to do planning and agile development. So one of the things that is nice about Microsoft Teams, and I would like you to consider this, you can add tabs to Teams, and in order to do that, come on. Okay. Here are all the tabs that you're going to have in your team. And to add more tabs, there's a plus sign in the top right. So at a minimum, I would request that everybody please add OneNote so they can keep track of their meetings. All right, here are some other favorites. Trello, MindMiser, OneNote, Freehand, Power BI. These are some other apps that you can implement into Microsoft Teams to make it easier. Mind mapping. If you guys have not heard about mind mapping, please investigate this more. It is an extremely powerful brainstorming tool that I have used extensively in the past on my project development and on my class development too. It's really good for developing a class, for developing software. So try to use mind mapping on your team and see how that works, with your team and see how it works. Power BI is for charts. So here's a thought. One of the things about the manifesto, it says that working software over comprehensive documentation. I feel that this is actually one of the points where agile development is reducing the effectiveness of engineering teams because it creates a situation where there is a high degree of knowledge amongst the team, and that knowledge is hard to share outside the team. But there are some tools to help it. But this is not true anyways. Documentation is a pivotal part of scrumming, and you need to have documentation. Oftentimes it's just a little bit different. Okay, so sharing of files. We've already talked about this in a lot of our classes. The rest of this is kind of boring, the rest of this PowerPoint slide. But utilize Teams in order to do agile software effectively. And I think that this is definitely a good process to use for this class, especially until we get to CDR. At CDR, we're going to move into physical development. And when we're developing the actual physical robot, you might want to switch to a different design method. You might like this method, and you might keep going with it. But communication is going to be of utmost importance in this class for developing your project. All right, so now we're going to go to Atlassian webpage now. And Atlassian makes some of the, in my opinion, the best tools for doing engineering development. And so I'm going to use their page because they also have great documentation on it. So Here are the team members that are on an Agile team. So you have the development team, and just because everybody has the name development team, that doesn't mean they're all the same. Agile really is trying to redefine the role of the development team. Previously in the waterfall method, you know, you had the testing, you had the system engineer, you had the device engineer, whatever, and they were all very disjoint. One of the things they're trying to do is increase communication amongst the team by having the entire team present at the beginning and throughout the entire process. So saying development team, you still have testing engineers, you still have delivery, design, development engineers, but the team is self-organized to suit the needs of the specific application of the design cycle. So you get the members of the team that you need and have them influence that team. So you have the product owner setting clear direction. Now the product owner, go back and look at these documents again. They're really good documents. But the project owner managing the scrum backlog, release management, and stakeholder management. This is a major, major thing. They are dealing with the stakeholders. They're making sure that what you're building is actually what's needed. So huge responsibility. And then the Scrum Master, holding it all together. The Scrum Master is focused on making sure there's transparency between the development team, the stakeholders, everybody understands what's actually happening. Self-organization, protecting the team. The Scrum Master really has the ability to make Agile development successful or unsuccessful. One of the worst things that I've seen using Scrum, using Agile, is that there's too much emphasis on delivering the product. And so all it feels like is every Scrum cycle, every week or every bi-weekly period, you're just sprinting the entire time. You have no time to mentally decompress. Part of running a Scrum, you need to make sure to take care of your people. Make sure that there's time that people can decompress after a hard press to the finish, so that you're not just doing hard presses to the finish every minute of every day. So protect your team. Scrum values, remove blockades. So this person is really trying to make sure that the team has what they need in order to achieve the goals. Okay? So those are the roles of the team. Now, sprints. Sprints are short time box period with the Scrum team works to complete a set amount of work. This is one of the things that makes Agile development much different than the other engineering processes, in that it has this fixed amount of time window where you're going to do whatever you can do in this window. The vast majority of the other development methods, you have a task, and however long that task takes, what you allocate for it. Agile is different. So in this way, it can address schedule much easier, because if you have something that is going to take a lot longer than you previously thought, after the first week, you can redo your schedule and push it out. Okay? So this gives you a lot more control over making Agile adjustments as you move forward. So here's kind of the view of how a sprint works. It's going to go back and back and back until you finish, and then you output a product. Okay, so it's a circular process until it's done, and then you release that revision. So you don't have to release something every turn. We'll get to that in just a minute. So for a sprint, you have the sprint planning, then you do daily scrums, then you do the sprint review and the sprint retrospect, and then sprint planning. And you continue on this cyclic pattern pretty much indefinitely. And that's one of the big things about software development that's different than hardware development. If you go back to that manufacturing process, design is done when that product starts rolling down the assembly line. You might go back and redesign to address issues, but for the most part, design is done. Software is different. Software is never really done. Okay, and that's something that a lot of people especially some of the more gray-bearded engineers, have a hard time with is this, it's never going to end. There's never an end to software. And that's one of the reasons they came out with this manifesto, is because they needed to address that mindset in the engineering world that you just have to have this stage A, stage B, stage C, then you're done. All right. So as you get into these, sprint planning, you can look through each one of these a little bit more in depth. But this is exactly what it sounds like. And down here, we have an illustration of the sprint planning. There are inputs into it. You need to address the who, the how, and the what, and then you need to set outputs for this planning meeting. And so you can go through and read this in more detail. I'm not going to go through all these in high levels of detail, but all right. Meetings or ceremonies, as they're calling them. Meetings, if they are done correctly, are a benefit to an organization. If they are done incorrectly, they are a major time sink and of minimal reward. So when you're running a project, make sure that when you have a meeting, there is benefit to the meeting and that you are just not having a meeting to meet. All right, here are some of the ceremonies or meetings that they go through. Sprint planning, and it says who needs to be there. Then you're going to have daily stand-up meetings, no more than 15 minutes. Don't book a conference room. Conduct it standing up. Standing up keeps the meeting short. And then iteration review. So this duration, 30 to 60 minutes. Again, it's going to be short. You're going to be effective in your time management. Retrospective. All right. You need the development team, the Scrum Master, the product owner, and this is at the end of an iteration. So Agile is about getting rapid feedback and making the product and development culture better. Retrospectives help the team understand what worked well and what didn't. Retrospectives aren't just a time for complaining without action. That's one of the big things. You have this continuous circle, this continuous cycle. Make your next cycle better. If there's something that's really impacting the team every cycle, address it, fix it, so you can make the environment in which you're working better. Because this isn't just about developing a product. This is about having a happy team. Again, we can go back to this manifesto and individuals and interactions over the process and tools. So if you're an individual and you're coming through some idea, it might be more important than the process. You might need to adjust something. All right. Those are the major meetings. One of the cornerstones of the Agile process is the product backlog. This is your to-do list. This is what is so important. And one of the things that I've said that we will be grading on PDR and CDR is your to-do list, your backlog. You need to know what is done, what is yet to be done, what is next that you're going to do. If you don't have a plan for getting from where you are to the end, you're not going to make it there. So this product backlog is extremely important in actually putting down on paper what you've got to do in order to get from here to there, so everybody's on the same page and everybody can move in that same direction. You can talk about it and the team can say, "Oh yeah, well we need to develop this thing." But you need to write it down and you need to write down the steps that you need to accomplish to get there. That makes sure there's effective team communication. So start with the two R's, a team's roadmap and requirements. We've been talking about requirements during the class. The roadmap, that is more like a schedule. And so you need to think about this. So one of the things with Agile, they've given everything a different name. So the roadmap is your schedule of how you break everything down. All right, so think about that. You have to keep on your to-do list, your backlog, or else it's going to get outdated very quickly. Stand-ups, we already talked about those a little bit. And then Agile sprint reviews. So at the end, you're going to review. So these are not retrospectives. They're not a time for saying what could be done better, for thinking about the process. A sprint review is about demonstrating the hard work of the entire team, developers, designers, product owners. This is from Atlassian. We keep our sprint reviews casual. Team members gather around a desk for informal demos and describe the work they've done for that iteration. Time to ask questions, try new features, give feedback. So this is a time where you get informed about what all the team is doing. You have had your head down doing your work, developing your code, developing your simulation, developing your test process. And then at the end, you're going to do kind of a show and tell with your team so that everybody understands what's been going on and everybody has a little bit more of a stake in the overall objective instead of just getting stovepiped into doing what they're doing. Because a lot of times when you're doing this meeting, ideas start to go, there's brainstorming sessions, people just break off into little discussions to really think of, hey, if you did this and I'm doing this, we could put that together and do this other thing, you know? So these should be, you should allow your people to talk, to think, to be proud of what they've done. Okay. And then the retrospectives. Reflecting on the past to improve the future. Between technical and non-technical teams, you can retro on just about anything, okay? And here is some of the, I had a hard time with my computer because of the screen share. Here's some examples. I wish Agile was rebranded, renamed, so that people didn't assume it means work really fast without thinking. And that's what I'm saying. Don't, the Scrum Master can make this very inconvenient for a team, or they can make it very well. So they have a posting board on their retrospective. Okay, now we're going to switch subjects. So that's Agile. Agile is a great methodology. It was something that in the 90s they started to look at and say, how can we make it better? How can we take this obsolete manufacturing process and change it into something that addresses the needs for this software development environment? So now we have another process. This is called DevOps. This is a combination of development and operations. So usually when you are doing a software product, you have the developers and then you have the operations team. And the developers will develop something and they still are releasing it to an operations team. DevOps combines those two. And so instead of Agile, which had the circular loop, now looking at DevOps, it has this infinity type process structure. And you plan, build, continuous integration and deployment, monitor, operate, continuous feedback, plan. So this is integrating the operation side with the development side, where Agile is just an operation or just a development framework. I have used this process flow in the past and it is extremely, extremely effective. It is developed a lot from Agile and it has a lot of the same kind of ideas. So DevOps is more than just automating the development pipeline. In the words of John Allspaugh, DevOps is about ops who think like devs, devs who think like ops. So here are three principles of DevOps. The first, system thinking. Emphasize the performance of the entire system as opposed to the performance of a specific silo of work or department. This can be as large as a division or as small as an individual contributor. Second way, apply feedback loops, creating the right to left feedback loops. The goal of almost any process improvement initiative is to shorten and amplify feedback loops so necessary corrections can be continuously made. And then the third way, the culture of continual experimentation and learning. Create a culture that fosters two things, experimentation, risk-taking, learning from failure. All right, so DevOps is another process, but it actually, in a lot of areas, they try to do kind of a hybrid between DevOps and Agile. Because a lot of companies really are embracing Agile, but DevOps, one of the main takeaways from DevOps is that it is applying automation to the development process, to where you do automated tests. You do every time you do a code commit, it kicks off a whole test cycle so that the deployment and monitoring of your software is easier and can feed back in. So actually, Agile and DevOps can go together very, very well, and they can be complementary to each other. So some key terms: DevOps, and this is doing continuous integration, continuous development on a software platform. All right, most of these web pages have been from Atlassian. Atlassian makes tool sets. They make tools that are custom catered to a lot of these process models in order to help make the process manageable. And I think their Jira software and Confluence integration, these are some of the best ways to develop a tool chain. I've used Atlassian in the past. I've used other tools. I'm not selling Atlassian. I'm just saying this is an example of how modern engineering process development is done. There's processing tools that help implement your ideas and keep you to a process. So here is an example of what it looks like when you're doing this. You can see all the team members, you can see that they're going through different sprints, and you can see the time left, the objective, the accepted code changes. And so there's metrics for viewing what you're doing and how well you're doing. Sorry. And then here is a schedule view of it. And here again is that dashboard view. So one of the nice things about the Agile workflow and the DevOps development infrastructure is that you have these very, very, very powerful tools that will help your team understand where you're at and where you're going. So as you get out into the job market, you might arrive at companies who are still doing things very antiquated. I hope that you think back to this class and say, hey, there are tools that can help us do things better, and maybe propose that to your engineering managers as a funds-saving investment to invest or investigate some of these tools that really, really, really can help an organization. All right, thank you so much, and I will see you in class.